Shalom Israel, all prayers and honor and glory goes to Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shah, the Wadi Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah, for giving us the apostles and the elders a great millstone, and all the Akim pushing the word in sincerity and in truth and being faith based. Okay, now the topic I'm going to get into, Lord willing, it'll be edifying to the hopeful elect. So let's get right to it. This is James. Matter of fact, let's start at 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. The Lord knoweth how to deliver the godly out of temptation. The Lord knows and knows who's godly and who is hopeful elect of. Just like he know the numbers of your hair on your head, okay? He knows who he's going to deliver out of this madness of this wicked society called America, okay? All right. The Lord knows how to deliver the godly out of temptation and to reserve the ungodly, the unjust, unto the day of judgment to be punished, okay? The Lord knows exactly who he's going to punish. The Lord knows exactly who he's going to save. Okay? Now, the choice is what role you're going to play. Okay? The role you're going to play. Which one? You're going to be punished or you're going to be saved from this temptation that's coming. Okay? So, you know, Lord willing, you the hope for the left. Okay? This is James chapter 1, verse 12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. Because the temptation that's coming is the RFID chip. Okay? That's that descriptor scale. Okay? That's it. That's the peak of everything. You take that mark of the beast, the Lord don't. You take that mark of the beast, the Lord don't want you. Which is the RFID chip. Okay. All right. The image is the system. The RFID chip is the one they're going to implant to you to make you a part of the system. Okay. And those who take that chip, it's going to be out of here. Okay. Let's get a scripture on it. It says right here, it says Revelation chapter 14, verse 9. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, sabach. Okay? You heard that, sabach? The same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of Yahweh, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire, nuclear bombs, Sabbath. So what are you telling your congregation, Sabbath? And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and the presence of the Lamb. Right? That means they're gonna watch you cook. Okay? So our temptation is based on you taking the mark of the beast, which is the RFID chip. It ain't 316. John 3:16, sabach. Don't make no goddamn sense for you to have all this wisdom, this knowledge that was given to you, and for you to throw that bullshit. You're falling short, sabach. You're not one of those that's going to endure. You're not a watchman of the Lord. back to our topic at hand. Blessed is, this is James chapter 1, verse 12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. For when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life. By you not receiving, by you not taking the mark of the beast, right? The RFID chip. You're gonna receive the crown of life. Okay? The Lord's gonna give you the crown of life. Alright? Prepare your soul. I'm quoting verbatim. Prepare your soul for temptation. Book of Sirach, chapter 2, verse 1. Prepare yourself for temptation. That is the hour of temptation. That is the moment of whose side you're going to be on. Satan or the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shem. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. For when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Okay? Don't you love the Lord Sabbath? No, you don't. You don't love Yahweh Shemel Shem. You're mad at men. Instead of doing the right thing, you're going to be mad at men. So I got no scripture here. I'm a little willing, a little fine. We're going to kick it off with this last one right here. Alright, because it seems funny. You're falling short for something that your wife is doing or whoever. Alright? You're falling short. That's your madness. You're taking it personal. This is business, right? Alright, we about our father's business, right? Don't we follow Yahweh Shah? Alright, I'm gonna read all the scriptures here in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 5 to 8. Okay. Okay, because this is insane. Okay, because this being tempted and going through what we're going through is a blessing. Because most men out here, they don't know what the hell they just here. They just here on earth. For you knowing this truth, you're blessed. Okay? This is Hebrews chapter 12, verse 5. And ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. You have forgotten. Okay. You got all this wisdom and you're falling short on the mark of the beast. Come on, you should be more wiser than that. My son, despise not thy chastisement of the Lord. The Lord is he has chastised you to get to his point. Gave you all his wisdom, and here you is. The mark of the beast is 3 John 3:16. What type of bullshit you are? Huh? What type of madness is this? My son, despise not thou the chastisement of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him. Alright, the men of the world, Yahweh Shemel Shah, which is great millstone, they have been rebuking you. Telling you no, you're doing that, that's not right. That's not right. But no, you decide to say that's right. For whom the Lord loveth, he chastises. Alright? The chastising is love. How all this is coming out is love. An open rebuke is better than a secret love with Sabbath. For whom the Lord loveth, he chastises and scorn every son whom he receives. I mean, a lot of people say you're a man of the Lord. I don't know. You know, that, you know, I'm just going up the spirit. You know? Yeah, I mean, when I came in the world, when I came into the world of learning the truth, I mean, it seemed like you could see who the Lord is dealing with. And you can see what men fall short. That's why it's always good to be humble and just shut the fuck up. And play your role. Alright? That's what you gotta learn how to do. You gotta learn how to shut the fuck up. Because I heard it's a lot more men that don't know nothing. Well, you are responsible, Sabah, to be teaching these men the right doctrine. Okay? As we don't. For whom the Lord loveth, he chastises the scorner. Every son whom we receive. If ye endure chastising, God dealeth with you as with sons. For what son is whom the father chastised not? You have been chastised, you have been rebuked. Open rebuke is better than a secret love. Right? Everybody know your business. Okay? Which is a good thing, because it tells you how to fucking act in this fucking society, because you gotta be responsible. You're responsible for people. Okay? If ye endure chastising, God dealeth with you as with sons. For what son is whom the father chastiseth not? What about your fucking kids? Okay? Don't you chastise your fucking kids about them? Or you let your fucking kids just run around like assholes? But if ye be without chastisement, whereof all are protectors, partakers, then ye are a bastard. Would you rather be a bastard or someone's son, Sabah? And not sons. We better be the sons of the living power, okay? And you have responsibility to do the right thing, Sabah. And what you have done, you have caused treason. Okay? You have caused treason. Alright? This is an open rebuke with love. Okay? With love. Not open rebuke is better than secret love. We're not secret with this love. We openly rebuking you, let you know what the fuck you did wrong, Sabah. All that wisdom is falling, it's been poked right out you. And it's leaking. Because you matter a few men. Okay, hopefully we didn't fall short on the edification. Barakatah Yahweh Shah, Kawadi Yahweh Shemel Shah, for giving us the apostles and the elders of great millstone. The true men of the Lord with 100% truth. Okay? Till next time, Israel, Shalom.